Hello children, continuation with the previous video lesson. Now I am going to explain the next representation of given data. The next representation of given data, yesterday I explained three representations. The fourth representation is double bar graph. Now, what is a double bar graph? A bar graph showing two sets of data simultaneously. Where we will use this double bar graph? Double bar graph is used to compare two data simultaneously. Suppose if I am taking one example here, the weather forecast of the following five cities as follows. Okay children, the cities I am taking it as Hyderabad, Bangalore, Delhi, Kolkata, and the last one is I am taking it as Chennai. The maximum temperature and the minimum temperature of the city in a day. The maximum I am taking randomly some 45 degrees centigrade, 40 degrees centigrade, 35 degrees centigrade, 36 degrees centigrade, 48 degrees centigrade, and the minimum temperature 25, 22, 18, 20, 29. Okay. Now how will you represent this data on the graph? On the same graph, I am representing this maximum temperature and the minimum temperature. So the double bar graph is used in the same graph. We can represent both the maximum and the minimum temperature. So let us see children. As usual, horizontal axis I am taking it as x axis and the vertical line I am taking it as y axis. The origin I am representing here. I am representing both maximum and minimum temperature on the same graph. So one unit I am taking maximum temperature, another unit I am taking it as minimum temperature. So for the city Hyderabad, we need maximum temperature one box and minimum temperature one box here. And you can leave one unit here and then you can continue with the next city, Bangalore, maximum and minimum. Leave one unit here and then the next city is Delhi, maximum and minimum. And leave one unit here and then Kolkata, max, minimum. And then leave one box and the next one is Chennai, max and minimum temperature. So on the horizontal axis I am taking the cities, one unit I am taking maximum and minimum here, and on the vertical axis, vertical line, I am taking the temperatures. So here you have to choose the scale. How I am choosing the scale? Totally depends upon you children. The scale is individual choice. Here I am taking, since it is 45, 25, 40, 22, 35, 18, all these things. So I am taking the y axis, one unit is equal to 5 degrees centigrade. I am taking one unit as 5 degrees centigrade difference. So first unit is 5, second unit I am taking it as 10 and 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, I can extend this line now, 40, 45. If the graph paper is very big one, you can extend the line there. Now children, see, the maximum temperature of the Hyderabad is 45 degrees centigrade. So I need to draw a bar here. So this is the maximum temperature, and then minimum temperature is 25. So minimum temperature is 20, 25. Is this clear, children? So from this I can compare that what is the maximum temperature of the city Hyderabad and the minimum temperature of the city Hyderabad. So this double bar graph is used to compare two at a time, and the maximum temperature of Bangalore is 40. So exactly at 40 degrees centigrade we have to join this bar, and this is 22. More than 20, so each box will have 10 lines, sub lines here, and each two lines you can take it as one. So two lines like that you have to take, and then it is more than 20, you can join here. So this is the minimum temperature, and then for the Delhi it is 35. And it is 80, so it should be less than 20. Next, for Kolkata, it is 36. It is more than 35. It is 20, exactly 20 you can take. And the maximum temperature of Chennai, you can extend a little bit, children, here. So you can take it 50 degrees centigrade here. It is 50 and it is 29, so less than 30 you can take. So these are the temperatures. If you want to specify specifically what is maximum and minimum, you can color with different color maximum temperature. I am coloring with blue. And the minimum temperature I can color with the red color. So this is in blue, and all minimum are in red. So you will get a beautiful graph where we can compare two temperatures, or even we can use for some other examples the marks obtained in term 1 and term 2 in different subjects. There also we can compare, and we can understand that how far we have improved in our marks. I think it is very clear for you. So double bar graph is used to compare two quantities simultaneously, or else two data simultaneously. And let us go with the next topic, which is in your 8th class now. Up to now we have all these double bar graph, frequency distribution table, pictograph, all these things are covered in your previous classes. Now we are going to start with the new topic in 8th class. What you have observed, whatever data I am giving, it is in a smaller one, that is not large data. Suppose if you are talking about 60 students marks in the subject mathematics, it is very difficult to gather all the 60 students marks. Suppose the class 10th results in the year 2019 and 2020, or in the previous year. So each school will have many sections, and definitely it will be more than 100. So at that time, if you have a large data, we have to use it as grouped data. So sometimes, however, we have to deal with large data. At that time, we have to group this data. How we have to group this data? So for grouping of data, we can represent two ways. One, by if you are using tabular form, we can represent as usual frequency distribution table. And suppose if I want to represent this group of data by a bar graph, here we have to use histogram. So if it is a tabular form, we can use frequency distribution table. If it is a bar graph, we have to use histogram. Okay, let us talk about a group data. Suppose I'm taking one example from the exercise number 5.1 sheet. Okay. Exercise number 5.1. The weekly wages in rupees of 30 workers in a factory are. The weekly wages means the salary of the workers in a week. Okay. So here we are talking about 30 workers at a time. So definitely we can consider it as large data. So the wages of the workers is as follows. Rupees 830. 835, 890, 810 is there in your textbook, children, but still to make you understand, I am writing on this board. 836, 869, 845, 898, 890, 820, 860, 832, 833, 855, 845, 804, 808, 812, 840, 885, 835, again 835, 836, 878, 840, 868, 890, 806, 840. These are the wages they have given. Using tally marks, mark a frequency table with the intervals as 800 to 810. Children, division of this classes, division of this group data, division of the group data condensed is known as, we are calling it as, this as class interval. Is this clear, children? This is new for you. Be careful. Please try to understand this one. This 800 to 810, I am calling it as class interval. Okay, this first number we will call it as lower limit. And the largest number, lowest number, we are calling it as lower limit. And the large number we are calling it as upper limit. Is this clear, children? So, what are the class, what is the class interval we have here? Class interval. Tally marks. See, children, the class intervals are 800 to 810, 810 to 820, 820 to 830, 830 to 840, 840 to 850, 850 to 860, 860 to 870, 870 to 880, 882, 890, 890 to 900. Why I am taking up to till 900? Because 890 is also there, 898 is also there. So these values will fall under this one. So children, this 800 we are calling it as lower limit, and this 810 we are calling it as upper limit. Now what is the class size here? Class size means upper limit minus lower limit. What is the value of upper limit here? 810 minus 800. You can take anything children. 820 minus 810 also same value. 830 minus 820 also same value. 840 minus 830. So 810 minus 800 is 10. So all the class intervals will have the same difference. You should not take like 800 to 810 and the next class interval I am you cannot take it like 810 to 819 and then 820 to 825. That is the wrong taking of class intervals. The class interval difference should be same here. So children, lower limit did you understand? Upper limit did you understand? And the difference between the upper limit and the lower limit is class size, and the class interval they asked you to take 800 to 810. That's why I'm taking 800 to 810, 810 to 820, all these things. Now children, you will have a doubt that 800 to 810, if I count it from 800, 801, 802, 803, 804, 805, 806, 807, 808, 809, the limit is 10 here. The class size is 10 here. If I include 810, the class size will become 11. So we have to include 800 to 809. We should not include 810 here. So the upper limit of the class interval is not included in this one. The upper limit of this class interval becomes the lower limit of the next class interval. So this lower limit always included in the class interval. Upper limit will not be included. Okay. So 800 to 810. So suppose you can count it like this. See ma'am, 830 will not fall in this one. 890 no. 812 no. 890 no. 835, 820, 840, 806. 806 will come under this one. Next. So you can count it 1. 890, 860, 885, 845, 810. Since the upper limit is not included, I cannot count 810. Usually you will do this mistake. You will count 810 in this one. Okay children, so this upper limit should not be included in this one. And 832, 835, 35, 32, no, 35, no, 36, 55, 36, 69, 45, 879, 845, 804, 2, and these are all not in these two. So how many we have? 2, and 2, and one more, 808, so 3. So the frequency is 3 here. And similarly, in between 810 to 820, 1, 810, 810, so we have 2 here, so this is 2. So similarly, we have to count for 820, 820 to 829, you have to check, 820 here, 9, right? So this is 1. Like that you have to count children. 830 to 840, let us see this one. Similarly we have to write all these things. 830 to 840, 30 should be included, right? So 1, 2, 40 should not be included, so I am not counting this, 2, and next 40 should not be included here. 30 to 40, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So totally we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As usual, like frequency distribution table, we have to do this one. So 9. the remaining will be 5 we have, and 50 to 60 is 1, and 60 to 70 is 3, 70 to 80 is 1, and 80 to 190 is 890 is 1, and 890 to 800 is 4. So totally 3 plus 2 is 5, 5, 6, 6 plus 9 is 15, 15, 20, 21, 24, 25, 26 plus 4 is totally 30 worker wages. This is the explanation of frequency distribution table. In the next video, I am going to explain histogram. Thank you, children.